It's All Things Considered, HPR1, and I'm Dave Lawrence. This is the music of Lily Hayden. The song is Sea of God from her new album, Lilyland. Lily Hayden, known for a variety of things to people familiar with her, her violin playing, diverse style of music, free-spirited upbringing, getting to play with a wide range of artists from Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan to Jimmy Page and Robert Plant of Led Zeppelin, and for her unusually spelled last name, Hayden, H-A-Y-D-N. We find out more as we welcome her to HPR1 and Hawaii Public Radio, Lily Hayden. Aloha, Lily. Thanks for taking some time for us.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you so much. Well, the truth is, and I haven't really talked about this, my mom made that name up.
Wow.
Lotus Weinstock was my mother, wonderful comedian, first woman to perform at the Comedy Store, and engaged to Lenny Bruce before he died. She decided that she wanted to be completely free of the Philadelphia Jewish lineage, and she came up with Maury Hayden. And then when Lenny died, she met my dad, and my dad was running from the law, so I couldn't use his name. I was called Cherub when we moved onto a commune. When I started acting, my agent said she cannot be called Cherub, so Lilith was my original name, and my mom decided that Lily Hayden was a good name.
What's your dad's?
My dad ended up going by David Jove. I've been so trained as a child never to utter the name. In fact, I was blindfolded as I was being brought to his house. He was known as the Acid King, because he was the first person to mass-produce LSD alongside Owsley Stanley. He turned on the Rolling Stones and the Beatles and was sort of hunted down all for what he said was turning the world on to God.
And he escaped, I'm presuming, from the way the story...
He escaped by convincing people he was crazy, which was not too much of a stretch, actually. I guess in that my parents were kind of renegades and didn't follow the rules, as I see what I do doesn't really fit neatly into a category, and that pretty much everything I do is kind of my own concoction. Certainly this record, which is not rock and roll, but it has elements of it because of who I've gotten to play with over the years. It's not classical music, although there's a lot of classical elements to it. And I guess my parents, they set the example that that's possible.
It's a way to honor them. Another facet of you. Lending a helping hand is sort of something that you do, whether it's breast cancer, United We Stand Festival at UCLA, 1 Billion Rising, Valentine's Day event, just some highlights from recent activities in your life, Craig Ritchie Project, Angel Food Benefit, lots of ways. When did that philanthropic side blossom, and talk a little bit about how it means something to you?
My mom was a stand-up comedian, as I mentioned. She was always performing for every benefit. It was just sort of understood that it was her way of connecting to the world, and it was just the right thing to do. And it was really just my mom and me. My dad would sort of pop in as this kind of good-hearted boogeyman. But my mom was always doing these fundraisers, and when she passed away, I really took that mantle. I think it was just kind of always understood. And then I think because my dad was abusive and my mom was kind of always being abused, beat up on, I had this passion to protect the underdog. Also, I was a couple years younger than my classmates in school, and I was always been little anyway. I was always picked on, so I understood what it meant to feel like the underdog. And so when I saw Mr. Smith Goes to Washington, Frank Capra movie, it was just, that was what I wanted to do. I wanted to be a human rights lawyer. I was going to defend people who couldn't defend themselves. And when I realized how effective, how moving music really was, and when I would play and make my music, people would instantly respond. I felt like maybe my way of effecting change would be to make music. My mom used to carry around a little Casio keyboard, and we would serenade people on the sidewalk if she felt like they needed a pick-me-up. And so I played in old age homes and cancer centers and in an actual elevator and in arenas. And for me, music is my connection to the world and that which we can't see as well.
And in honor of your mom, a vehicle to give back.
Definitely, definitely.
It's a wonderful tribute to Mom that you did that.
That's how we honor our legacy. I mean, ultimately, I think even when we rebel, we end up coming around and it's a little introspection, realize that we are inextricably linked. You know, there's a way of redeeming that, taking the best, and actually by letting go of what wasn't the best part of our parents, we actually help with their redemption.
We further their greatest generosity and their open-mindedness, acceptance of people.
Yeah, exactly.
The record is Lily Land, Lily Hayden, a fascinating person to speak to. Thank you so much for being on All Things Considered. It means a lot. Hope you had fun.
Thank you so much. Total fun. Great to meet you. I hope I get to see you in person.